In the previous videos, we mentioned that microgrids will play a great role in the increase of renewable energy sources penetration in the power system. In this video, you will be introduced to the definition of a microgrid. You will learn about its main operating principles, strategic aim, and main components. We will identify what are the four main characteristics of a microgrid, how can a microgrid be represented, and its advantages when compared to the traditional distribution grid. In the existing literature, there is a wide range of definitions for a microgrid. The microgrid concept was introduced more than a decade ago. According to Curtis Europe, a microgrid is defined as a series of electrical loads, elements of generated power supply, and storage elements that, connected to the electric grid by means of a single point of connection, are all linked through a strategy that manages both the flow of energy within the grid as well as the interchange of power with the main supply grid. Even though there are several definitions of a microgrid, it is possible to name four main characteristics that are common to them and that a microgrid should always feature. First, a microgrid is an integration platform for local generation, storage, and demand, all placed within a local distribution grid. Local generation is typically found at low voltage levels, and it is generally known as microgeneration due to its load scale. Second, a microgrid should be able to work in two operation modes, both grid-connected mode and emergency mode or islanded mode. Third, microgrids enable an active operation of distribution network. Management and coordination of this architecture makes the integration of microsources possible. Fourth, microgrids may operate in multiple scales. A low-scale microgrid could typically be a house with PV panels, power converters, and loads. A medium-scale microgrid could be a factory. An example of a bigger-scale microgrid can be a university campus or a neighborhood. This slide depicts three layers to represent the operation of power systems. The highest level is the power grid layer, where generation, transmission, and distribution are carried out. Typically, the electrical power is generated by large-scale power plants or renewable energy-based farms, such as wind or PV farms. Then, the generated power is transferred through the transmission lines to the loads, generally located at the distribution network. The second layer, or intermediate layer, within the distribution network is defined as utility service area, which may include various residential, industrial, or commercial regions. This second layer may also include a notable number of microgrids. At the lowest level, you will find a microgrid, which may consist of a few feeders or electrical components. A supervisory control system can be present, and distributed generation units may be connected. Next to the main control system, demand-side management schemes can be optimally implemented. Microgrids have several advantages compared to existing passive distribution networks. They are more resilient to failures, disturbances, and faults, particularly if battery storage systems are present. They can provide a higher efficiency, especially because the power is generated at the point of use. They allow the integration of higher levels of clean renewables, due to which they are much more environmentally friendly. On top of this, microgrids have the potential to highly reduce the need for heavily polluting power plants like coal-fired units. Microgrids have the potential to provide a higher flexibility thanks to higher integration levels of storage, as well as the implementation of supervisory control. Higher flexibility means that, for example, it is possible to integrate more renewable energy sources. Also, microgrids are less vulnerable when they are subject to disturbances or faults. This is possible because they can operate in islanded mode. This mode can be enabled through the implementation of suitable control and protection schemes. Unlike conventional power plants, microgrids can be created in a modular manner. In this way, they are more independently maintained and controlled. Also, electrical components are easily replaced, upgraded, and aligned with current standards. Microgrids can be operated in islanded mode, particularly during faults at upstream electrical network. This may lead to higher reliability and higher continuity, of supply. In summary, in this video, we defined a microgrid, and we saw that there are four main characteristics that must be present in every microgrid. A microgrid is an integration platform for distributed generation and loads. It can work either in grid-connected or islanded mode. It is characterized by active operation, and it can be found in multiple scales. Then we identified that the electrical power grid layers and the potential benefits that microgrids can provide to both the main grid and the consumers. Among these benefits, we find higher resiliency, efficiency, and modularity. Also, due to the higher participation of renewable energy sources, microgrids can be more environmentally friendly than passive distribution systems.